Hi there, I'm Rach from Squarestylist, and in this video, I'll share how we can accomplish one of the most commonly requested features in our community, which is to add a custom image cursor to your Squarespace site. You'll be able to upload your custom image or vector. I'll also share some guidelines on how to make sure that this custom feature won't interfere the navigation experience of your users. And I also thoughtfully wrote the code such that your editing experience while in edit mode won't be disrupted by the custom cursor. Our first step is to make sure that our custom image or graphic has the correct specification. It's important to take note that our image or graphic should not exceed 128 pixels in width or height. And I typically use either 30 pixels or 50 pixels. So feel free to change the dimensions accordingly. If you need help resizing your custom graphic, then you may use the tool that I developed called Pixresize. And all you need to do is upload the custom image. Then we specify the width to be less than 128 pixels. Typically 50 pixels would be fine. Let's max out the quality to 100%. And we need to change to the PNG format to keep it transparent. Once we process the image and download it, this will now be compatible to be your custom cursor. If you can, it's best to export the graphic as an SVG file. That would make sure that the cursor won't be pixelated. But if that's not available, then a PNG file that meets the specification to be less than 128 pixels would be totally fine. Our first step is to upload our custom graphic to our site. We can do so by adding a temporary page on the not linked area of our site, and then we can attach a hyperlink. In this case, we need to attach a file. Once you click the upload icon, we'll simply select our cursor image. Make sure that this is selected. And once we save our work and click this link, the link will lead us to the file path. This is the path that we will insert to the code that is provided with this resource. So we just need to go to our custom CSS panel. And again, you can access that by hitting the forward slash on your keyboard, type CSS, and it will lead us to the custom CSS panel. If we paste the code, all we need to do is insert this file path within the quotation marks. And once we save it, we'll notice that our custom cursor is now showing up on our page. Feel free to delete this temporary page after uploading our custom cursor. Please note that these custom graphics might not show up if your site is still on trial. But be assured that they will show up as soon as you subscribe to a paid Squarespace plan. By default, this custom cursor will only show up as a default cursor, but once you hover over important links or buttons, then it will switch to this pointer cursor, which is ideal for accessibility. But if you wish to have a custom cursor, even upon hover of links and buttons, then you may use the second code snippet that's provided with this resource. Simply paste the code snippet, and this time we need to reference the file path of the custom image specific to when a link or a button is hovered over. It's best to have a different custom image for that. So in this case, I uploaded another file path, and notice once we hover over a button or a link, then our custom image cursor for links is now showing up. While this is such a cool way to make your site unique, I recommend being cautious when customizing cursors because it might affect the familiarity of the navigation and the entire user experience. If you found this video helpful, I'm sure you'll also enjoy some of our other Squarespace tips and resources. This next video is all about a hidden font hack that allows me to create high-end magazine style layouts on Squarespace. I'm also publishing design resources and tips regularly, so please make sure to subscribe to our channel.